your name followed by the pound key.
The translation of the word is, it's a command, it's a directive from Hashem to the Navi or to the Navi that they should console my nation. Yemer Elokeichem, this is what your God is saying. Dabra Alei Yerushalayim, speak on the heart of Yerushalayim, Bekiru Elohim, and call upon it.
Where's the rest of the books? No. Can I book these? Thank you.
Tzorich lehovin. In this pasuk, we need to understand mahu. What is the significance? What is the illusion? Hakfelos, the duplication, the double. Nachamu, nachamu ami. Console my nation. Rashi Pirash Rashi explains this pasuk thusly: Atem neviyam, you my neviyim, nachamu asami, you console my nation. Bahainu, which means the way Rashi presents this pasuk, the context, it means Yezehu hadibur anvim. That this is actually a directive, a talking to the Nevi'im, she'enachmo es Yisroel, that they should console the Jewish people. V'gam zeh ne'emun, that too needs explanation. It's not readily understandable. What is the difficulty? Mahu inyan hadibur l'Nevi'im she'enachmo. What is the significance? What is behind the sinyan dibur l'nevi'im, to speak to nevi'im, that they should consult the Jewish people? V'halei, is it not dibur hanevuah, the expression of the nevuah that comes from Hashem to the Navi, zehu guf hanuchom, that itself is already in the chomer, is already a consolation. Hashem says to the Navi, I'm consoling my nation. That's a very consolation. What is the Novi? What is the significance of Novi done repeating it? When he says to the Novi, Nachamu, that you should console, Harei Hamashmos, the implication there is Sheyesh as a Nachomo, that there is some kind of a consolation. Leva Dibra Hanvuatz. In addition to the words of the Nevuah itself, the Nevuah is a word from Hashem. What kind of consolation is there in addition to that? Thus we need to understand Mahu Hanachom Hazois. What consolation is this that is beyond the consolation of the Nevuah? The Medrash Rabbi Yiso, in the Medrash it says, Lots of if you fly him, when the home will be fly. That Yerushalayim, Lots of if you fly him, he was smitten in a double measure, when the home will be fly him, and he's being consoled in a double measure. When the mover, that itself, we cannot understand. Mahu inyan loksu b'kiflayim. What is the significance? What is the implication of Loksu Bikiflain. What's behind this? He was punished, he was smitten in a double. Eich Shaykh, how is it conceivable? She Yechas V'Sholem Ho'enesh, that's V'Sholem, that the punishment should be Bikiflain Malachet, in double. Over the sin, over the transgression.
Rabbi,
yeah.
What is the chet that is spoken of here?
The Yerushalayim sin. The Yerushalayim was destroyed because of their sin, of their zora, whatever it is.
There was one particular sin.
No, the chet that was accumulated. The accumulated chet.
Refers to the two destructions. Right?
What?
It refers to the two destructions.
To the what?
Both destructions.
Both destructions.
Nachamu is
only for the first.
After the first, this is the Novi, the Neviim. After the second,
right.
There were no Neviim.
What? I'm just curious about this word Lukka. Leket is Leket Shikha and Peya.
No. Leket Shikha is not Lamed Kufta. Yeah, Tess. Loksa is a top. Loksa, like smitten.
Okay,
let's not just waste our time.
Yeah.
Eich Shayach Chatzisholm Ho'inish Bikiflaim Achat. How is it possible? How is it conceivable that the Oynesh Chas V'Sholem was doubled of the Havodachet? Maybe Shemohan Chama Bekiflayim. The second part of the statement here, the Chama Bekiflayim, that it be a double consolation, that we can understand. A double consolation means console double over the punishment, over the suffering. That we can understand. Why? Who this? That is mipnei. This is due to the fact shemidot teiva maruba. That midot teiva, the midah of goodness, is greater than the midah of punishment. So we can understand that even though the punishment was a certain measure, he said, but man, I mean, the console will console in a double measure, over and above what the suffering was. Aval, but on the other hand, Mashayach Loksa Bikiflai. What is the possibility that it should be Loksa Bikiflai, and what does it mean that he was smitten in a double measure? Umipnei Shiloksa Bikiflaim, and then the Pasuk says further. Because of the fact that it was smitten in double measure, lekach nichamo bekiflayim. For this reason, it was consoled in a double measure. That's what the pasuk says, nachamo ami, and then the next verse is kiloksu mi'ad Hashem, because it was smitten from Hashem. Now, was the double the consolation is due to the double punishment. We need to understand what is altogether the union of the double. Furthermore, we need to understand Masha Kosu, what the Pasuk says, Dabru Vikiru. The Pasuk says like this. Let's go back to the top of the line. I don't know if you're familiar. Nachmu Nachmu Ami, console my nation, Yemer Alekechem. Hashem said, Dabru Alev Yerushalayim, speak on the heart of Yerushalayim, Vikiru Eileho, and call upon it. So now we're going back to this Pasuk. What does it mean? Dabru Vikiru, speak and then call. The Lechoeira Eine Mu'em Ezek Fiyah said, it would seem to be out of order. Because kriya, calling, has to precede speaking. Ukmesha Kosov, as it says in the Pasuk elsewhere, Vayikra El Mesha Vaydabit. Hashem called Mesha and he spoke to him. So speaking comes after the call. Call means Come to me, I want to talk to you, and then you start talking. Why then does it say over here, Tchilo Dabro? First it says speak.
Press 1. Returning to the conference room.
First we say speak, and then you say Tchilo. Call. Hi, the questions are quite blatant and superficial. But to understand all of this, we have to reintroduce again what we had already discussed earlier. Namely, we said that the 10 spheres of Atzilus hang between his Chalkus, Milo, Umato. They have the element of his chalkus, of the vision, milo umato, higher and lower. This is a subject that has been discussed in our great variation, in great depth. So very briefly, his chalkus, milo umato, the vision divided by, it's not all one reality. But there is Milo Umat, there is that which is high and that which is low. Sheha Chochmo, this is the Eses Filis. Chochmo is the tip of the Eses Filis. Ha Chochmo hi bivchinas. There's obviously a word missing here, and the footnote over here does not correct the word inside, but it just footnotes the missing word. And even there it says, perhaps it's missing. It's quite obvious that there's a word missing here. Sheha chokhma hi bivchinas mailo lagabi bina. That the chokhma is in the mailo bivchina lagabi bina, relative to bina. So here is the first illustration of mailo mato, chokhma relative to Bino. Chochmah is a Milo legabi Bino. We already learned and discussed it, but we'll refresh it in a moment. V'amoichin bichlal, and moichin, the intellect in general. Qu'est-ce que c'est?
It's for recording audio later. We're trying to find a solution.
Oh yeah, okay. Hey, bimchinas milo legabi zo. In general, moichin overall are in a milo bechina, the milo sense. Legabi zo, relative to zo, the rampin refers to the midas, chesed gvura tiferes. V'chein, and likewise, zo legabi malchus. Zo. Say Rampin, the midas, all the midas are in a Milo quality, legabe malchus, relative to malchus. Sheho, shehi, malchus is bechinas save for the chol darkin the atzilus. The end, the chol darkin of all madrigas of atzilus. This is the bottom of Atzilus. Have a good day. This was a big principle that we discussed, that in Atzilus, the Esesfiris Atzilus, are so imbued with such a principle, with such an oir of Milo Umato, of higher and lower. When Yisboir, further it was explained, The Milo Mato, that is upper and higher and lower, who be basing yon, is identifiable and expresses itself in two inyon, in two principles. O Aleph, the first, Mepchines Ribu Yemiut, in the aspect of Ribu Yemiut, of more, numerically more and numerically less. What is that referred to? Shebehasfira Hoel Yeino, where in the highest sphere, Ho bechinas ribay hoir. There is the aspect of ribay hoir, of a greater amount of the oir. And what is greater amount of the oir? What is this greater oir? The hain of which means bechinas hagilu the oir in soy baruch. A greater gilu of any soif. So the highest sphere. There is more gilui of Eirin Seif. This is the short Milo. More cognizance of the Eirin Seif. Umismayt, umisalem, hoir, madregal, madregal. And then the oir is reduced and becomes more concealed. It, so to speak, misale means self-conceals. Mimadrega le madrega, from one madrega to the other. Misale means the grammatical meaning of the word misale means it self-conceals, because it does not have a place to fit in the lower spheres. So it retracts. Mimadrega le madrega, from one madrega to the other. This is the meaning from Milo Mata, that in a higher Madriga there is a greater forthright expression of the higher of the oir. In the lower Madriga, the oir retracts itself. There is less revelation, less expression of the Oyer Seif. Less cognizance of Oyer Seif. This is one aspect where the Milo Mata is identified, the Habez, and the other Inyan of this Milo Mata is Be'etzem Mahusum Madrigosum. In contrast to the first of how much Oirin Soif, how much Oirin Soif reveals itself there. Here we talk about Be'etzem Mahusum Madrigosum, the very essence of their own reality. The sphere is their own reality, Madrigosum, and their Madrig. Shehasfira Hoel Yoino, where the highest sphere, he bivchinas Milo, is in a Milo aspect, bivchinas Milo, in a highness aspect, be'etzem mehuso, in the very essence of reality, gabe hasfira shalomato, relative to the sphere that is mato mimano, that's below it. So I'd like to discuss this for a moment. We don't have much time anyway, but it's important we revisit this principle. Let's take the human being relative to other creatures in the world. The human being has faculties that are infinitely superior to those similar faculties in other creatures. the intellect and the emotion and so forth are of a different quality.
To remain on this call, press 1.
He can comprehend in his intellect, and in his intellect he can relate to concepts infinitely superior to those that are available to other creatures. Spoke many times just as a simple illustration. The sky is an open edifice to all creatures, equally open. When the human being looks at the sky, he sees a different richness than all other creatures. This is the union that that the significance of what he sees is allowed to be revealed to him with all its multiple colors and all its designs, all its beauty. Because he is privy, he is capable of appreciating it. This is why it's revealed to him. This is simply in terms of the oir, of the impact that is provided to him. In that respect, he is infinitely superior to all other creatures because of, in from the perspective of what is being allowed, what he's allowed to see and appreciate. Then there is another aspect, which is called be'etzem mahusu madrigosu. The very essence of their mahus, of their reality. We always point out the phenomenal difference and the principle behind the fact that a human being stands up erect. Not only does he stand up, but he stands up erect, but he stands up, so to speak, he can't even physically explain how he stands. His stance is a heavenly stand. It's a divine stand. It's not a physical stand. To physically stand on the ground, you have to stand on all fours. His stance represents a different reality, a different madriga, a different principle of a being. I've said many times, he is not earthbound, although he stands on the ground. He stands on the ground, but he's standing on the ground independently of the ground. This is a distinction. I'm sorry. Be'etzem adrigosem, but identifies their very essence of what their truth. Witness, you know, an infant in a crib is already trying to stand up. Although he's incapable of standing, but he climbs on the first thing. He's only trying to stand. Much easier to crawl. He stands up and he falls and cries and he stands, and that doesn't deter him from standing up again. His greatest joy is when he stands up. Stands up, he begins to smile. Because there he realizes his fullest being. This is the other aspect of Milo Umato. He is Bivchinas Milo. He is a Milo, he's in a Milo element. He is not in a Mato element where he descends downwards and wants to be supported from the bottom up. No. He wants to be supported from the top up. He wants to relate to that which is on the top. And he wants to be independent of everything else and just to experience and to function at his own recognizance, so to speak. His own reality. This is in the spheres also. There's moichin and midas. Moichin are this independent entity, conceptualizing things that do not necessarily have any practical inferences. Midas, I'm already trying to translate this in, so to speak, an experiential level. Within that itself, each madrege in its own is very different. Chochma is primarily is an essentially different than Bina. As you pointed out, this is a phenomenal thing. It's important to understand. Chochma does not even seek to understand what it understands. What you show me, that's what I see. Doesn't even seek to translate it in its own abode, in its own element. It's okay where it is. That's where I relate to it. This is the way it is inside, which is a moshul for chokhmah. Bina is where we try to translate it, so to speak, in the human realm. This is the Milo Mato among the spheres themselves, the koiches, the spheres, and then the Milo Mato in the general sense of there's individual spheres, and then there is the Milo Mato in the general, the creature itself, like the human being, relative to the other creatures. That's a madrigosum, imhusa madrigosum. The very essential definition of human being is not because he has seichel. He's a different kind of creature. As you pointed out, an infant, before his seichel begins to function, he already wants to stand up. All right, so this is it for this morning. And we will reconvene Mitzvah tomorrow again. Have a great day.
So where are we leaving off?
In the next place. Okay.